علي. ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهد الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. I greet everyone with the most beautiful greeting, the greeting of Islam as well as the greeting of Jannah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. MashaAllah, Jamaat al-Muslimin, it's a beautiful feeling to see everybody coming back to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We actually had a guest speaker today, but somehow the traffic it doesn't allow him to be on time. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes it easy for him. And may Allah make it easy for me as well, inshaAllah ta'ala. So we'll take the time just to thank the community. To thank everybody that comes to the masjid. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala should truly reward you. Indeed, we know that the day of Qiyamah, subhanallah, the person that's going to be able to stand under the shade of the arsh of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, on that day when there will be no shade, it is a person whose heart is connected to the masjid. And alhamdulillah, as we see, our time goes, everybody is starting to realize that how can we stay absent from the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Although we take our precautions, we have to take our precautions, but the houses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala needs to be opened up. This is the place where we need to come to in order to reach out to Rabbul Izzati wal Jalal, to the one who is Shafi, the one who gives cure. We need to come to him and we need to speak to him. And inshaAllah ta'ala, if we are the true worshippers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who have the true yaqeen in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who have the true tawakkul in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all our trust is not in humankind, it's not in the creation, but in the Creator. If we are those, inshaAllah, with 100%, without a doubt, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will answer our prayers, inshaAllah. Du'a to a believer is ruhul ibadah. It is the essence of a believer and it's the essence of worship. Another narration says, du'a huwa al-ibadah. The du'a is ibadah. It in fact is ibadah, it is worshipping. So subhanAllah, the way that we are worshipping, it is to reach out to the one, subhanAllah, who can answer our prayers and who promises us that وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمْ أُدْعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ. He, subhanahu wa ta'ala, is teaching us that if you come to me and ask me and beseech me, then I will be the one to respond. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is waiting for us, Jamaat al-Muslimin. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is waiting for us with open arms. And we need to run to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asking him. So inshallah, we really are grateful for everybody that comes and contribute to the masjid. Please don't stop contributing to the masjid. We know that COVID did a lot of harm to many of our masajid. And you know, some of masajid need to be maintained. And mashallah, some of the masajid do great outreach work. And mashallah, our masjid being one of them, doing community work, mashallah, assisting many, many organizations as well. And it could not be possible if we have people like you in our community. So we are really thankful. And also, those, mashallah, who comes to the masjid and abide by the laws. I see today one or two maybe might have been out of line. They came and they just put their musalla down. There is a protocol that we follow. Alhamdulillah, we didn't have huge problems. But inshallah, you know what? We are grateful for everybody that does that. If we come, inshallah, there will be, what do you call it now? People that stand at the door that will guide us, this guide will tell us how to follow the rules, inshallah. If we can stick by that, inshallah ta'ala, no issues will happen. So we are grateful as a ummah of sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We are those who always consider. We have great consideration for our next fellow, whether it's a Muslim, whether it's not a, whether it's a non-Muslim, alhamdulillah. And this is why, inshallah ta'ala, we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allahu Akbar, ashraful makhluqat, the most honored of Allah's creation. He teaches us in a beautiful statement that he made in a hadith where he says that مَنْ لَمْ يَدْعُ اللَّهُ يُغْضَبْ عَلَيْهِ. In another narration, مَنْ لَمْ يَسْأَلِ اللَّهِ, that whoever does not ask or beseech Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala becomes angry with such a person. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's messenger encouraged us that we should turn to Allah in whatever case it may be. Whatever difficulty I find myself in, or whatever ease I find myself in, how do we do this? By showing gratitude, inshaAllah ta'ala, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Going to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in prayer, going to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in dua, and crying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The ummah today has lost the touch on crying. Our sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is when he used to speak to Allah is what? He used to cry. He used to cry for his ummah. He used to cry for anything. when he's sitting with his creator, then one-on-one time, he used to cry to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Badr is a great example for us. Although he knows he's Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he knew he was the beloved of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But that particular night, he understood. And he made the Sahaba, his companions understood that we are not an ummah who's always relaxed. We are an ummah that will always turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No matter if I'm Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, no matter if I'm Habibullah, he cried for an entire night in dua and beseeching Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What was the call? Ya Allah, if this handful group of Muslims, of mu'min, of believers, is not going to be victorious today, then your name will never be mentioned on the earth. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he is ma'soom, he has been forgiven for all his shortcomings and sins. No, we don't want to say the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sinned, but he has been forgiven for all previous and future. Yeah, he's crying an entire night, asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the canty that that group of 330 men, meek, weak, starved, they come in and they're going to fight in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? Because they're standing for haq. This is amazing. This is a lesson that we can all take. That whatever the circumstances, no matter quantity, no matter what it is, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promises that if you call unto me, then I will be there. وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and when my worshippers ask you about me, then I am close to you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is close to us. Do we want to know how close Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to us? We understand that because Allah gives the answer. وَنَحْنُ أَقْرَبُ إِلَيْهِ مِنْ حَبْلِ الْوَرِيدِ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that I am closer to you than your jugular vein. How come it is that we still have doubt? How come it is that we still hold on tight to the rope of this world? But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us that وَاَتَّصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعٌ وَلَا تَفَرْفَقُوا Hold on tight to not the rope of creation, hold on tight to the rope of the Creator Allah. If we hold on tight to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, can we imagine? Can we imagine what would happen? Imagine all the 1.6 billion, put this in brackets, for some statistics state that there's much more than 1.6 billion Muslims in the world, alhamdulillah. But let's say 1.6 billion. Imagine everyone coming together in unison, crying to Allah for what is truth, crying for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in changing our character to being good. Because mashallah, the one thing that will weigh the most on the day of Qiyamah is going to be what? It is our character. It is the way that we conducted ourselves. Because he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came with many things, but the most outstanding thing came with his what? It is his character. He says, Bu'ithtu li'utammima makarim al-akhlaq. I was sent to perfect character, to show you how you should act in this life. With what? Now, subhanAllah, sharia is complete. Al-yawma akmaltu lakum deenakum. And our deen has been completed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's perfected. How? The way that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam conducted himself. With trade, with business, with your mothers, with your parents, with your children, with your neighbors. Any situation we need to find. And how should I conduct myself? Wallahi, you'll find it in the lifestyle of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So how many of us know this? How many of us know actually how to trade? MashaAllah, we have business. Alhamdulillah. And may Allah bless us in our business. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase us in our businesses. The point is, how do I conduct myself in my business? A simple example of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's character. He's a most amazing person. Every time we read about it, we do read the same thing over and over. Allah, he amazes us. It is whereby somebody who lived in his household could say that not for almost 10 years, I've been living with him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And at once he said, why did you do that? Or why did you not do that? Allah Akbar, amazing. Nothing, not becoming angry, not uttering a word for a person to feel uncomfortable in his presence. But everyone that was in his presence, how did they feel? Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum, they mentioned. He said that you felt that you were the most important person in the presence of the Messenger of Allah. You felt like he loves you the most. Can we maybe, subhanAllah, find somebody today that would say, Wallahi, Moulana, you love me the most the way you treat me. May Allah grant us that. I don't know if I'm that person. I'm trying, subhanAllah. But if I come in your company, Allah, I always feel, if I give you that smile and you smile back, that to me says a million things. Some of us, we are very morbid people. I don't know why. Allah knows best. Maybe it's corona. May Allah protect us. SubhanAllah. But wallahi, when we reach each other, when we greet each other, it is such a wonderful experience to meet your Muslim brother with a greeting of peace. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Can you imagine what you are saying at that moment? And giving it with a smile. It will happen. Wa alaykum assalam wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. We don't know what is actually happening there. That is, you know, that is what you call it, chemical things that is happening there in the brain. MashaAllah, I'm free from every harm from this brother that is greeting me now. He has a clean and pure heart towards me. Amazing. That is what we should feel at that moment. Wa alaykum as-salam, my brother. No, I feel exactly the same way. I love you so much for the sake of Allah. That's why Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala, they never missed a period of time where they greeted each other. They challenged each other with greeting. Because they understood that this is a sunnah of the Messenger of Allah that gives us more reward than a fa'l. The one who greets first. Today, you come inside like, oh, they didn't greet me. Why didn't they greet me? Don't they know who I am? Somehow we don't know who we are. Because we ask, do you know who I am? We know who we are. We know our shortcomings, but still we think we are superior to others. Cry to Allah. This is the time now that we need to cry to Allah. Ask Allah to forgive us. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us. Spend now in the cause of Allah. Because what does the spending do? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned that it takes away the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So spending the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Somehow we feel that if we are going to spend, I'm going to have less. Allah promises you. You won't have less. Allah will increase you forgiving. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had his loss. And what did he do? He gave his loss. Aisha radiallahu ta'ala and responded, Ya Rasulullah, this is all we have. Give. Give. Wallahi Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will return for us in multiplication. He will give us more than we even think about. And that is what does that develop? If we do the things that the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam came with, then what does it develop? It develops in us taqwa. And what does taqwa do? Taqwa gives us that sense of contentment. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is in control of everything. He subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَيَتَّقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا. The moment you gain that quality of taqwa, of God consciousness, of fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, correct way, what will happen? Then Allah opens up the pathway for us. Health, wealth, every ease. And immediately after this, Allah mentioned, وَيَرْزُقُهُ مِنْ حَيْتُ لَا يَحْتَسِبُ. This is a time of distress, difficulty, subhanAllah. A believer should never think like that. A believer is, this is a test from Allah, and we will pass the test. Because Allah says, if I have the consciousness of Allah, وَيَرْزُقُهُ مِنْ حَيْتُ لَا يَحْتَسِبُ. How many of us can say that we starve throughout this period? Alhamdulillah, we're still fine, we're still okay. Barakallahu feekum. Inshallah, guest speakers are right. May Allah bless you, inshallah. Ameen ya Rabbal Alameen. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will open up the way for us, inshallah ta'ala. Allah open up the way for everyone. Because it will come in ways and means unimaginable for us. We can't fathom this. وَمَنْ يَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ. Place your trust in Allah, فَهُوَ حَزْبٌ. Because Allah is enough, inshaAllah. Moulana, I'm not sure, this is the time, it's already 1 o'clock, inshaAllah ta'ala. So Moulana should do the Arabic for us, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He says, Jazakumullah khairan for everyone who came. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you with health, with abundance of wealth, to do more good, inshaAllah ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless your families. Allah grant you to be close to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in this life and in the next life. May Allah grant us all to witness Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How can we achieve that? Raise our hands in dua. Cry to Allah. Let's bring back the sunnah of our tears being, you know, come from our eyes, roll down from our eyes and our cheeks in order to make things better for ourselves and to consider the entire mankind like the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had a concern for mankind. Let us have that attitude as well. Attitude of gratitude. What we have, our attitude shows gratitude, but also our concern is how everybody can be successful, inshallah. Barakallahu feekum. Akhir da'wana ila rabbil alamin. Assalamu alaykum.
حي على الفلاح.